Hi everyone. Today in this video we are going to discuss about Mupirocin. What is this drug Mupirocin? This is one of the topical antibacterial agent that is having broad spectrum of activity. This drug can be used to treat skin infections such as impetigo. In the young children we can observe impetigo, which produce some red sores around the mouth as well as nose. And some skin blistering can be observed along with itching of the skin. So on the skin, blisters are formed, otherwise red areas can be observed along with itching of the skin. All these can be treated by this topical antibacterial Mupirocin. And this Mupirocin is a natural antibacterial agent obtained from Pseudomonas fluorescens. Since it is obtained from the Pseudomonas species, previously, this drug is also known as pseudomonic acid A. This Mupirocin is having broad spectrum of activity. It is effective against gram-positive infections as well as gram-negative infections. But clinically, it is indicated against gram-positive bacteria which produce skin infections. Particularly, it is effective against Staphylococcus aureus infections, similarly Streptococcus pyogenes and Staphylococcus epidermis. In all these infections, Mupicon can be used as antibacterial agent. So today in this video, we are going to discuss how this drug acts, what is its chemical nature, important precautions, side effects, all these things we will discuss in this video. Now let us see the chemical nature of this Mupirocin. So this is the structure of Mupirocin. We can observe a large structure, but within this structure, we can observe an ester functionality. Here ester is formed along with alpha beta unsaturation. So this moiety can be compared with another structure. This is nothing but crotonic acid. That's why Mupirocin is a crotonic acid derivative. It is an ester formed between the crotonic acid and an aliphatic acid. So what is this aliphatic acid? So this is the aliphatic acid, which is having 9 carbons with terminal OH group. So this is nothing but 9-hydroxy nonanoic acid. So Mupirocin is an ester formed between crotonic acid and 9-hydroxy nonanoic acid. Now let's see how this drug acts. Mupirocin is mainly inhibiting the bacterial protein synthesis, and for the bacterial protein synthesis, one of the important component is the tRNA. This tRNA or transfer RNA brings each amino acid every time, such that the amino acid chain can be increase to produce a specific bacterial protein. Now, one of the important amino acid that is targeted by Mupirocin is the isoleucine. This tRNA cannot bind to the isoleucine directly. It requires an enzymatic activity to bind to this amino acid. So, one of the enzyme responsible for binding of amino acid to the tRNA is the amino acyl tRNA synthetase enzyme. So here, since the amino acid is isoleucine, this enzyme is called as isoleucyl tRNA synthetase enzyme. Now this enzyme is having the different pockets on which all the components are going to bind to produce amino acyl tRNA. But in order to produce this activity, energy is required in the form of ATP. Now in presence of ATP, isoleucine can bind to this enzyme. During this binding, hydrolysis of ATP takes place, which results in the release of energy required for this reaction. Now here, isoleucine as well as ATP both bind to this enzyme, where the diphosphate bond is going to be released by hydrolysis. In this way, hydrolysis of ATP results in the formation of AMP, adenosine monophosphate, along with release of energy, and this energy is utilized for binding of isoleucine with the AMP. In this way, isoleucine occupies its binding site on this enzyme. The next step is the addition of tRNA. Now tRNA can bind to this enzyme where it can form a bond with isoleucine. At the same time, the bond between AMP and isoleucine is going to be removed. Now this tRNA, which is attached with the amino acid, is called as amino acyl tRNA. Now this isoleucyl tRNA can be released from this enzyme, which is ready for incorporation into the growing peptide chain. So this is one of the crucial steps in the protein synthesis of the bacteria, where the isoleucine is incorporated in the peptide chain. Now here mupirocin shows its activity. Mupirocin can bind to this enzyme, thereby it inhibits the enzymatic activity. So in presence of mupirocin, all these components, isoleucine, ATP as well as tRNA, they cannot bind to this enzyme, so that they cannot form the amino acyl tRNA. In this way, mupirocin inhibits the bacterial protein synthesis by inhibition of producing isoleucyl tRNA. What are the precautions? So when this drug is applied on the skin, it can produce some local reactions. So on administration of mupirocin on the skin, it produces local irritation. So care should be taken to use this drug for proper indication, particularly for Staphylococcus aureus infections and Streptococcus pyogenes infections. This drug is useful. So without proper indication, this drug should not be used, because this drug produces local irritation resulting in the burning, pain and itching on the skin. Similarly, when this drug is applied on the mucosa, just like on the skin, this drug, when it is applied on the mucosa, it can produce some drying of the mucosa as well as some irritation of the mucosa. So again, it should be avoided on the mucosal administration except at the nasal route. Similarly, what is the effect of mupirocin on the eye? Actually, this drug is not intended for ophthalmic purpose. It should be used only on the skin. But when there is an accidental contact between the mupirocin and eye, it produces severe eye irritation, which results in eye pain as well as itching. So if any contact is there between the eye and mupirocin, immediately it should be washed with plain water in order to minimize the irritation. Similarly, another effect can be observed on the nose. So when the skin ointment of mupirocin is applied on the nose, it can produce some nasal irritation, stinging, nasal discharge, nasal discomfort can be observed. That's why nasal ointment of mupirocin is preferred, which shows some less nasal irritation. Another important precaution of mupirocin is that this drug can produce some Clostridium difficile associated diarrhea, commonly known as CDAD. Since this drug is having broad spectrum of activity, it can increase the growth of Clostridium difficile. So Clostridium difficile can produce the two types of toxins, toxin A as well as toxin B. Both of these toxins can produce one of the condition, pseudomembranous colitis. So this condition results in the diarrhea in the patients. And Clostridium difficile can also release hypertoxins, which further increase the pseudomembranous colitis. So care should be taken to monitor the development of pseudomembranous colitis in the patients, because this condition is produced by many of the antibiotics which are having broad spectrum of activity. Similarly, this mupirocin can also increase microbial growth. So this drug can increase the fungal growth in the patients. So for bacterial infections, it should be carefully used. On prolonged treatment, it can increase the topical fungal growth. Similarly, this drug can increase the systemic allergic reactions. Anaphylaxis is one of the important reactions that can be shown by mupirocin, and it can produce urticaria, skin rashes, and angioedema. So any swelling, skin rashes, erythema observed with mupirocin, care should be taken to avoid these allergic reactions. What are the side effects? The important side effects are mainly related with the skin irritation. So this drug can produce some burning, stinging, local pain, skin rashes, dry skin, nausea, erythema, reddening of the skin, and it can also develop contact dermatitis, swelling, tenderness, some itching as well as exudation can be observed with this mupirocin. How it is given? This drug is available as ointment as well as cream. The dose of the drug depends on the weight of the ointment that is going to be administered. Each 1 gram of the ointment contains 20 mg of mupirocin. So a small amount of the ointment should be applied 3 times daily. And the treatment can be extended up to 10 days based on the efficacy of the treatment. So that's about this topical antibacterial agent mupirocin. This drug is a natural antibacterial coming from the Pseudomonas fluorescens. And this drug is also called as pseudomonic acid A. And chemically, this drug is a crotonic acid derivative which forms an ester with 9-hydroxynonanoic acid. This drug is effective against Staphylococcus aureus infections, Streptococcus pyogenes infections. And this drug can be used in the treatment of impetigo, which produces red sores, around the nose as well as mouth, blistering of the skin, some skin rashes, itching. These can be treated by this mupirocin. Local irritation resulting in burning, stinging and local pain are important side effects of this drug. But this drug should not be applied on the mucosa, where it produces drying of the mucosa. And any accidental contact with eye produce some eye irritation. This drug can also induce Clostridium difficile associated diarrhea. So care should be taken to monitor any symptoms of diarrhea developed in the patients. And this drug is available as ointment as well as cream at a dose of 20 mg per each gram of the ointment. It should be applied 3 times daily. Up to 10 days, this drug can be used to show its efficacy. So that's for today. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.